Hey there, my fellow music lovers. Welcome to the channel. Thanks so much for stopping by. I really do appreciate it. In this video, I wanted to give my thoughts on the brand new tune that just dropped from Yes, featuring Jon Anderson, Trevor Rabin, and Rick Wakeman. It's called Fragile. Where have I heard that name before? I don't know. Might be Yes related, I'm not sure, but yeah, this is a brand new tune. This is something that we've been kind of anticipating for quite some time. We've heard that there could be some brand new material coming from this particular lineup. What's interesting is that Trevor Rabin and Jon Anderson have not worked under the Yes name for over 20 years, not since the Talk album, and Trevor has never worked with Rick under the Yes banner, and they've been wanting to do something forever. The last time that Rick Wakeman and Trevor Rabin worked under the Yes name was in the early 90s when they did the Union tour, but that wasn't in the studio, that was just performing live. That's one of the reasons why Trevor wanted to do this ARW thing. Of course, he wanted to work with Jon, but really wanted to work with Rick finally and work with him in the studio. And so now this song has not been officially released. It aired on a radio show called Jonesy's Jukebox, which is a show hosted by Steve Jones. He's formerly of the Sex Pistols. Now, why Trevor Rabin went on this show with these brand new tunes and decided to let them out of the bag there, I do not know. And so, yeah, Trevor brought a couple of songs with him to this radio show. One of them was the new tune Fragile. The other was a new live version of Owner of a Lonely Heart, which he just got through remixing in 5.1 for the upcoming DVD Blu-ray Live at the Apollo, which is going to be coming out on September the 7th. And that is from their show in Manchester on the last tour. So you'll definitely want to check that out. And I didn't get to hear Owner live, actually, because they didn't include it in this interview clip. And I haven't heard it surface either, but that's probably just as well considering the really shitty quality of this audio from the radio show. But I would assume that with the DVD about a month out, we should be getting an official live clip soon enough, as well as something for this Fragile track, this new song, I would think is going to be coming out soon too. And I'm going to get to that in just a bit. I wanted to kind of go over some things that I pulled out of this interview. One of them was that Rick Wakeman didn't want to fix any errors or anything. He wanted it to go out warts and all, which I'm sure must have just been just lovely for Trevor. You know, he's a perfectionist. He kind of loves to make sure that things are perfectly right before they go out. So I'm sure that he did a great job with the 5.1 mix and everything, but he wasn't able to go in there and tweak it to death. Also, he mentioned that the band has the legal right to the name Yes if they want to use it just as it is, but that management would prefer to use a distinction. And I could see why that would be a good idea. I mean, I'm sure the paperwork would get a bit messy with just having, you know, two bands with the same exact name. He also mentioned that they prefer to do shorter tours because they're too old. And that's one of the differences between this version of Yes and the other one with Steve Howe, is that the one with Steve Howe likes to tour a lot. They do a lot of summer tours. There's definitely a difference there. And I think one of the reasons is just because the other band, you know, I don't think, well, first of all, you've got like Alan White, who has got some back issues, but they've got a young drummer who can come in and take his spot, you know, and the other guys seem to be in fairly good shape and ready to go. Whereas Wakeman has had his health issues, Jon Anderson has had his share, and Trevor, you know, who knows what's up with him. He probably can do it, but just prefers not to. He really hasn't been on the road a whole lot over the past 20 years anyway. But I also get the sense that Trevor Rabin is a vegan. And I haven't heard much talk about this, but I picked up on a couple of things from this interview that makes me think that. One of them is that they were talking about South Africa and about hunting. And Trevor mentioned that he wasn't a fan of killing animals. And then they were talking about zoos. And Trevor also talked about how he wasn't a fan of those because of the captivity aspect and, you know, taking animals out of their natural habitat. And that's very much a vegan point of view. And I'm not knocking them or anything. I'm just, you know, picking up on it. And plus, you factor in that Trevor is in really good shape for his age. I mean, that's one of the things that I noticed when he got back with the band is that he looked really good. He didn't look like he had gotten out of shape or anything, which we tend to see with some of these guys when they start getting into their 60s and 70s. I got to give Trevor credit for keeping himself in really good shape. And so that's why I kind of think that he may be vegan. And if you have any ideas on it or if you know, drop it in the comments below. All right, so let's talk about this new song, Fragile. You know, if you just listened to it without knowing anything about it, you would probably think it was a Jon Anderson song. And he certainly has put his stamp on it, but actually it is a Trevor Rabin song. It's a song that was supposed to be part of a film project, but it wound up not getting used. So it was like extra footage. And he showed it to Jon and Rick, and they really, really liked it, wanted to work on it. And so this is what we get. And I get the feeling that this song is really about how fragile life is. It kind of reminds me lyrically of that song by Sting of the same name, which was on his second solo album, Nothing Like the Sun. The same kind of a sentiment. The song starts off with, goodbyes and endings bring tears to our eyes, talks about how time moves so fast. And you start thinking about how this may be tied in with Chris Squire's passing, how it really affected Trevor. And of course, you know, Jon Anderson was really sick at one point too. And I have an interview that I uploaded that I did with Jon, which I'll put a link up to. Jon talks about how when he was really sick, Trevor called him and was always asking him, like, you know, how are you doing and everything. And I think that's one of the reasons why we even have these guys doing this now is because Trevor realized that, hey, you know, time is short. You know, I want to work with Rick. I want to work with Jon. Let's do this now while we're all still here. And so the song just has a very, it just kind of has this attitude and this sentiment of, you know, appreciate things now because nothing lasts. You know, one of the lyrics is time to recover. All things must pass. Look to another. And it kind of has this sentiment of like, you know, something ending and then something starting again. He even says, you know, such a sacred life we live. Touch. Then he says, be the touch, which, you know, saying that be the touch kind of makes me think he's talking about, you know, be in the moment, you know, don't take it for granted, that kind of a sentiment. It's just really, really beautiful, I think. And when you take a look at the music, I think it fits it like a glove. We're talking about life being fragile, and I think the music is very, very delicate too. When you listen to the keyboards, you know, the piano that Rick has, it's kind of like it just kind of like washes over, little drips and drabs coming in. The guitar, there's different styles of guitar kind of coming in and out. The vocals are very, very light. The drumming is very, very light. It's got a delicate approach to a delicate subject matter. And I just think it's very well done. The shame in all of this is the production quality that we can't hear. And that's because of the clip that we're listening to. I even debated doing a review until I heard it officially. I could only imagine that in all its glory, it probably sounds really, really good. And then one of the things is that the song kind of ends abruptly, which I think is appropriate because that's how life is, you know. You never know when things can kind of come out of the blue and change you forever. I mean, look at what we've got going on now. We've got fires that are, you know, destroying people's homes out in the West here in the States. I've known people who have lost their homes. Some people have even lost their lives. You can have it happen with a flood, a hurricane. It could be a disease, you know. And then if that doesn't get you, time will, you know. And it's just, you know, everything, like I said, everything ends. And, you know, the way that it kind of ends abruptly kind of speaks to, I think, what this song is trying to say. I've heard some people talk about how this might be a demo or like a work in progress. I didn't get any sense from Trevor in this interview. He never said, oh, this is something that we're working on. It's not finished yet. I get the sense that this is it. You know, why would you bring it to a radio show for everybody to hear if it wasn't finished? That doesn't sound like Trevor. Anyway, I'd like to know what you think of this song. Be sure to put your comments below. I know for myself, I've listened to it probably a dozen times. I think it needs to be listened to multiple times to really get a sense of it. It's not one of these cheap crap songs that come out nowadays where you hear it once and you pretty much know everything about it. This is a song that kind of reveals itself. There's a lot going on here lyrically, the music. You know, it'll be really good when we get a better quality version. I'm sure there's stuff that's buried in this shitty quality that we can't really hear. And it kind of reminds me of maybe Soon from the Relayer album. It kind of reminds me of maybe a mixture of Holy Lamb from the Big Generator album, along with Where Will You Be from Talk, something in between those two songs. It definitely sounds like Yes. It sounds like a modern version of what Yes is. You know, Yes, I know there's some people that are bitching and moaning about how it doesn't rock and it's not this and that. Look, you know, Yes is not just about one thing. You know, you guys should know that by this point. You know, Yes is about contrast. You know, there's very soft things, there's beautiful things, and then there's times where they are rocking out and it's very, very dramatic and all that. And this song just happens to be, there happened to be leading off with something that's a bit more quiet. And I think it's a beautiful song. I really, really do. So let me know what you think. Put your comments down below. Give this video a thumbs up. If you like it, hit that subscribe button if you haven't already. And I will be back soon with another video.